So I'm George Haritakis. I work as a software engineer at Prodyna, and we are going to see a bit about database transactions in Golang, to be specific. But first, let's see some goals. Okay, first of all, my main goal is to promote a little bit some Go features, Golang features, and to bridge the gap between different generations. Thus, the initial title about Gen X, Z, and Y. Okay, so we have Gen X. It's approximately of the age you see. And the main skill is database. I say that my presentation is full of clichés and stereotypes, but of course I don't believe all of them, but they are realistic. Imagine that in the past there are many of the business logic existing in databases. There's a little knowledge, of course, of I would say software, front-end, back-end, and stuff like that, and less knowledge of Kubernetes, DevOps, and all these kind of things. Then we have millennials, less database knowledge, more software-like knowledge, and medium knowledge regarding the cloud and Kubernetes stuff and all the DevOps, as I have said before. And we have Gen Z. The cognitive load is huge. They have many, many options, many technologies, many tools. They know how to scale a deployment. They know how to write Terraform scripts. They know how to do GitLab pipelines. But sometimes the knowledge in the software section is not so great. And the database knowledge is lacking, I think. That's why I'm doing that presentation. Hopefully, all of the generation will learn something, or if they already know, they will find something interesting regarding the Go implementation. So, what is a database transaction? A transaction in a database management system is a set of logically related operations executed as a single unit. So, in a single, let's say, call, we have many, many operations. Operations can be read, write, commit, or rollback. Read and write is pretty much explanatory, self-explanatory. Commit is when you have an action performed or many actions, and that state that exists in memory, you write it in the actual database, and rollback is that when you take everything back. There are some properties there, is the ACID properties, as we say. Atomicity. Atomicity ensures that all operations within a transaction are completed successfully or not completed at all. Consistency ensures that a transaction transforms the database from one valid state to another valid state. We have isolation, that the concurrent transactions do not interfere with each other. And durability, that once a transaction is committed, the changes are permanent. Even if the system fails, they are still permanent. And some more stuff that you can Google. There's a concept that says that there are different transactional isolation levels. Here you can have some idea about what those are. And there are transaction states that there's another concept you can see there. So imagine that we have a simple scenario. Most of you know about Game of Thrones. That guy is called Jamie and is a rich guy, and his sister is called Cersei. And Jamie wants to give some money to his sister. Spoiler alert, they are lovers too, but we don't care here, no judgment. And after that action is performed, we want to write that transaction back in a papyrus, let's say, in order to keep record of that thing. Okay. So, if we translate that simple scenario into an SQL-like query, that's not accurate SQL, but it's like a pseudocode in SQL, we have the following. First, we update the account balance of Jamie. We remove there 100 coins. Then, as a second operation, we add that amount in Cersei's account balance. So, until now we have two operations, and as a third operation, we write that record in the database table that the transfer has been done, for example. That can go wrong whenever an operation fails. We are going to come to a state that it's not desirable, and that can cause problems. Regarding the generation, I said before, when we have such conflicts, usually the Gen Z trying to find in Discord or in Slack someone, probably if it's from Gen X or Y, they don't know what Slack or Discord is. And usually they say Gen X, like boomers, they say to change something in the database, and they are reachable only via email, primarily. So we have a generation gap there too. So the concept of the transaction can be seen here. At first, we declare, I repeat, it's not a real SQL query. I have only described it. We say that a transaction is going to begin, and until we define how it ends, commit or rollback, we have a single unit. So whenever we have something that fails, for example, when the operation 2 is fails, automatically operation 1 is cancelled. The same happens with the third operation too. So that three operations exist in a single transaction. Okay, let's see how that can be translated into Golang stuff. First of all, here I have some definitions that describe how our program reacts with a database. There are two tables. Okay. So at first we have two tables. One is called accounts, and the other is called bank records. Accounts table has already these persons, and bank records currently is empty. You can see here the balance of the coins. So we have an account repository that's a struct that contains a database, and here we call it constructor function. It's how we initiate that struct, and the same happens with bank records. It's like the repository pattern in Spring Boot or .NET, but translated into Golang stuff. Okay, then we have here in the DB file the operations that we do in the database. That part says that getCoin method can only be run under the reference structure. That's called receiver, method receiver. And actually it means that that function that is actually a method has to do with that account repository. So it can run under that account repository. And we have one operation that says get coins. We pass account ID and we get the number of coins. For example, if I ask for account ID 2, I get 0 coins. We have another operation that says add coins. We say which account we want and how many coins to add. The same applies to remove coins. We also have another operation that says create bank record. It refers to the other repository, other table, that one, that we define there the amount from is the one who gives the money and to is the one that receives the money. And the record ID and created are automatically filled. Okay. Then we have another layer. We call it service layer. That first of all, we create a connection to the database that we want with that line, and we initiate those two repos. We say that in that specific situation, Postgres is going to be connected with accounts repository and bank records repository. And here in service, we have like our business logic. We say we want to print the status. If I print that down, we see that Jamie has 30 coins and Cersei 0. So in total, we have 30 coins. Now, if I run the same without a transaction, let's see that no transaction business logic, what it does. First, it removes the coins, how many coins? 2, from account ID 1. Account ID 1 is Jamie. Then add those coins in Cersei and creates a bank record. Now, if I introduce an error there, it means that it will remove the coins from Jamie's account. Those coins are not going to be added in Cersei, and of course, no bank record is going to be filled. To be exact, if I run it, I see that at first we had total of 30 coins, and now we are in 28. And that happened because of a connection timeout, let's say. It's a custom error. Okay, so we are in a state that we don't do, we don't need to be in. Let me upgrade that again. And running into a transaction. There's another logic there that I call it DB logic transactional. Okay. Mm-hmm. Correct. Okay, and what it does? That's another great feature of Golang. We have a method that says execute transaction, and it takes a database, and it also takes a function that inside it we pass a transaction. And that is how it is implemented. So, first of all, we begin the transaction as we have seen earlier. If there's an error, we handle that. And the function that we pass in as a closure, we execute it here. If there's no error, we commit the transaction. And if we have an error, we do a rollback. So we have specified our transaction logic. It's a pretty generic thing here. And by passing the functions that we want to run inside that, we can have a very generic transaction method for the most of our operation. Reusable things are not very reusable at all times, but currently it works well. And the actual transactional logic that we want to run is the same as before, but is declared in another repository, db_tx. The only change is that instead of passing here DB, we pass the transaction. And if we try to run it, by also introducing an error, I will introduce an error here again. We can see that although the transferred coins removed from Jamie's account, there was an error, so everything was rolled back. That was pretty much regarding Golang stuff. Let me go to the final slide. So, as a conclusion, of course, that implementation can be done better in layers or more generically, but this was just a showcase to show you how a transaction can be done in Golang. Something that I think is very important is that early consideration of transaction is not premature optimization. It can easily be done from scratch. In general, all these transactional operations must be tested with stress tests, and they can also be done in a database level. Something that I tried to do and I highly recommend is to keep that transaction in a closed scope, to encapsulate it, let's say, and not passing around, because there are solutions out there with transaction handlers that you, whenever you want, you can pick up a transaction and pass it in many places. And something that is also important, that there are many databases, primarily NoSQL databases, that do not support transactions. So when we want to implement rollbacks there, we have also to implement the rollback of the actual operation that we have done. For example, if we have written something in a a database that does not support transaction, we have to take it back manually. Thanks a lot. I will upload the presentation in GitHub. Thank you.